Good morning. My name is Tessicine Elio, a Level 1 BSN student. So today I'm going to perform the return demonstration on bed making. So bed making is the proper adjustment of bed linens accordingly to promote patient comfort and to prevent the spread of microorganisms. So there are four purposes of the bed making. So number one, it helps the clients to feel comfortable. Number two, this is to decrease the pathogens on the client's environment. Number three, this is to allow the patient to have a clean, dry, and wrinkle-free linens. And lastly, this is to help reduce potential for skin breakdowns, and it is very important to help control odor. So now we're going to the principle. So under the principle, we have principle of infection control and principle of body mechanics. So under the principle of infection control, we have microorganisms move through space in air currents. And lastly, microorganisms can transfer from one surface to another whenever one subject touches another. And under the principle of body mechanics, a person or an object is more stable if the center of the gravity is close to the base of support, and then facing the direction of the task to be performed and turning the body in one place. And lastly, lower the heads of the client's bed before moving the client. So now, we're going to perform the making of an anakipay bed. So first, we're going to perform the hand hygiene. This is to prevent the cross-contamination. So now we're going to assemble the equipment and arrange it on a bedside chair to the order in which items will be used. So this is to be more systematic and will save time and energy. So the arrangement looks like this. So first we have the bottom sheet followed by our rubber draw sheet. Under the rubber draw sheet we have the draw sheet and then the top sheet, and then lastly we have the pillow piece. So now we're going to adjust the bed in the high position. Then we're going to drop the bedside rail. So adjusting the bed to the high position will facilitate the proper body mechanics and also will prevent or avoid muscle injuries. So now we're going to disconnect all cold valves or any other tubes from the linen. So this is to prevent the damaging of equipment or devices. So next we're going to put clean gloves on our hands. So this is the proper way of putting the clean gloves. Proper way of seeing the things. currently from tagging and also from clearing of the linens. Then using the linen as you move around the bed will save you time and effort. So this is on the head of the near side. Next, we're going to fold all soiled linens such as sheets, spreads, or blankets in time on the bed porch. So this is to save time and energy. So folding linens as they are on the bed reduces strain on the nurse's arms. Snapping, we're going to roll soiled linens inside the bottom sheet and place it directly into the laundry hamper. So we're going to place it on the pillow case that will serve as the laundry hamper. Rolling soiled linens snugly and placing it directly into the hamper will prevent from spreading of microorganisms. So the floor is heavily contaminated and the soiled linens will contaminate or further contaminate the furniture. So soiled linens contaminate the nurse's uniform and will spread the contamination to the patient. So if possible, we're going to shift mattress off the head of the bed. So this allows more food to move to the patient. So now we're going to remove the cleaning gloves and dispose it into the proper disposal. So now we're going to place the bottom sheet with its center fold in the center of the bed and high enough to have a sufficient amount of a sheet to tuck under the head of the mattress. So please be in mind that the wider hem is on the foot part. So loosening all tightness on the bed reduces strain on the nurse's arm, and then closing the sheets in the ensures the sufficient coverage of both sides of the mattress. Now we're going to unfold it. Then we're going to perform the fan folding. This is the proper way of doing the fan folding. So now we're going to place the draw sheet in its center fold in the center of the bed, placing it or positioning it under the in place under the head of or the under the patient in section. Place it under the draw sheet or over the draw sheet in the proper area. So not all nurses use or not all agencies use draw sheets routinely. So nurses may decide to use a rubber draw sheet. So the rubber draw sheet will be placed on the at the top of the bottom sheet and below the draw sheet. So we're going to place first the rubber draw sheet, then the draw sheet. Thank you. if the patients were in the bed, the draw sheet and the pad can change without the bottom and the top linens on the bed. So having all bottom linens in place before tucking them under the mattress will avoid the unnecessary moving about the bed. So, draw sheet aim on moving the patient in bed. So now we're going to tuck the bottom sheet under the head of the mattress. So, and then we're going to do the migraine on the one side of the bed. We're going to make a corner according to the agent's clubs. So, if you're using a heated bottom sheet, it allows or eliminates the need to migrate the corner. So, now we're going to tuck the remaining bottom sheet and draw sheet under the mattress and also the rubber band. So this is the proper tucking on the mattress. So now, before going to the other side of the bed, tuck linens may be placed on the bed, unfolded, secure, and allowing the inner side of the bed to be completed at one time. So having the bed on the one side and completing it to the other side will save time. So having all linens free of wrinkles reduces the patient discomfort. So now we're going to move to the other side of the bed and secure the top sheet under the head of the mattress. So we're going to first secure the bottom sheet and then we're going to migrate the corner. Organisms in the air and holding linens overhead the blanket over the foot of the bed on the near side. So we're going to do that. And then we're going to minor the cord. So this saves time and energy and gives the top cleanness or top sheet. So now we're going to fold our 6-inch chest of the top sheet or over the spread and lay it up. So this will allow the patient to enter the bed to sleep. So now we're going to move to the other side of the bed. And we're going to secure the bottom sheet under the head, under the foot of the bed. So we're going to secure and tuck it under the bed. And then we're going to miter apart. Making it on the one side of the bed will will save time and energy, and also this will make it more sufficient. So now we're going to cross the pillow. We're going to place the pillow in bed. Then we're going to open the pillowcase in the same manner as of opening the mittens. Then we're going to gather the pillowcase at one end towards the closet. Now we're going to cross the pillow with the hand inside the pillowcase. And we're keeping a firm hold on the top of the pillow. Then we're going to pull the pillow to the cover. Opening linens by shaking them, spread or getting sensitive to the air, and covering the pillows while it rests on the bed to reduce strain on the nurse's arm and back. So now we're going to place the pillow on the head of the bed with an open end toward the pillow. So pillowcase, by opening pillowcase should face away from the door. So prevent the contamination. So now we're going to fine fold the top linens. So having open linens will have a convenient, convenient for the patient to get into the bed. So now we're going to secure the hand signal of the bed according to agent's policy. So this is to allow the patient to call for the assistance as necessary. So now we're going to adjust the bed to the low position. So having the bed at the low position will get it more easier and safer to get into the bed. So now we're going to dispose soil maintenance according to agency policy and spread the spread of microorganisms. So now we're going to do the making of an obstetrical bed. So first thing we need to do is we're going to fold the top sheet on the food box. So this is to allow the patient to get into the bed. Away from the entrance.